Hi, my name is DelLisa Eddington and I'm a nurse practitioner. And I've been asked to show you some cool demonstration techniques on how to locate organs in the body. We have a wonderful volunteer right here who's willing to allow us to work on her. This is Liz. She's a friend of mine, another nurse practitioner. And I'm going to be teaching her, and she's going to learn how to do these so that you can see that whole learning process. So we'll start by feeling the stomach. You've got the stomach area right here on the abdomen. If you come up here and follow the rib cage line, you can feel the stomach and the lesser curvature. There's a little knot that you feel, a hard knot. That's the pyloric sphincter. So this piece is one side of the stomach. If you come along and push it, the stomach isn't a solid organ, so it's not like you can feel it on the other side. You have to come back in and actually palpate the ridges of the stomach underneath. Remember, you've got to go through the skin tissue, you've got to go through the subcutaneous tissue, the layer of fat, and the peritoneum before you can get into the abdominal cavity. And once you find that, you can palpate and appreciate the edges of that stomach. So this is her stomach right here. And you can hold it right between those fingers. Do you want to find it?
Mm-hmm. So first I go here along the ribs, and mm-hmm. I find the pyloric sphincter.
Follow the ribs up almost to where you'd come in to find the sternum. You'll feel a little hole.
Right.
That your hand will sink in, and a harder circular edge.
Yeah.
That holds. That's the lesser curvature of the stomach.
Okay.
Can you feel a harder mass underneath your hand?
Right there.
That's the pyloric sphincter.
Okay. And now I'm going to be trying to palpate
the other edge of her stomach. So feel here, as you come along, you just slide your hand just a little bit through. You'll start to feel an edge where it just kind of, you can actually cup the whole sac of the stomach. Stomachs are a little harder to palpate because they're soft. And they're a lot lower than you think. Stomachs truly don't come this way. They'll actually form a sac that comes up and around. So if you feel like you can't feel it, just keep going lower on the abdomen and see if you can't palpate or appreciate an edge. One tip too, the deeper you are, the harder it is to palpate. The softer your hands are, you can fine tune little feelings.
There.
You feel it?
Uh-huh.
Mm-hmm. And you can actually hold that piece of the stomach and actually kind of appreciate the whole piece of it. And the stomach changes, right, with what we eat or drink. So you can find it down here, you can find some tucked up here. People who have a herniation of the stomach through the diaphragm, theirs will actually be tucked up higher. And it just needs to be moved down. So there's the pyloric sphincter. That's something you're going to need to find in medicine. The next thing is to palpate a liver. We all palpate the borders of a liver. You know, you come in here and palpate it. Have you had your gallbladder out?
Mm-mm.
Okay. When you palpate, this is one of the first things you learn in medicine, right? You can palpate and feel the edges of that liver. The gallbladder sits about mid clavicular line right here. So if you can palpate that border, and then you'll start to feel a difference in the texture, and then it'll disappear as that border goes out. You can actually palpate and appreciate the gallbladder. It hangs out like a thumb right underneath there. So when you come along, feel the border. Does that hurt?
Mm-mm.
And right here is where her gallbladder lies. So I'm going to let you palpate it and feel both edges.
Okay. Right there.
Yep. You feel it?
Yep.
It's kind of like a little balloon. In some patients who are having gallbladder trouble, this gallbladder will swell, right? If they have gallstones, it'll swell and you can actually appreciate the lining bigger. Or when you come and they have the diffuse generalized pain and you feel that gallbladder and you hook it or palpate it, you can actually cause an increase of the sensation or the problems Then you can be like, I'm pretty sure this is gallbladder because here's the problem. I can move the gallbladder and it causes a lot of pain. That's our problem. That guides my direction on where to go for examination as far, and follow-up, right, and diagnosis, differential diagnosis. The next thing that we wanted to talk about is the colon. Like, we're going to kind of just move down a little bit. The colon actually...
So I'm going to interrupt you.
Okay, go ahead.
Use your fingers to, mm-hmm. to do some measurements. What are you doing there?
So basically, I just looked at her belly. Her colon should be here, is where I'm guessing her colon to be. So I kind of just walk it down.
Okay.
You can actually come through and feel the duodenum and the circular shape of the duodenum. And we'll kind of get to that in just a minute. But let's look here first, and then I'll show you where that goes.
Okay.
So what you want to do is feel the whole colon is actually like a water balloon, right? It's a pouch that you feel. You come off the hip, feel your fingers sink in, and bump up against a softer pouch. Like I said, water balloon. And as you wrap your fingers around, you can actually feel where that colon goes. It's tickly, sorry. As you go through, you'll feel a harder knot to where that junction is, the ileocecal junction, where it actually falls into the colon. So I'm not going to tell you where that's at. I'm going to let you palpate it and see if you can find it. Without tickling your purposes. Sometimes when they're laughing too, you can say, okay, come feel with me, and you take their hand. Then they're a little less ticklish, but not always. Sorry. It's hard, huh? It's hard not to laugh.
I'm very tickled.
It's right there, I think.
The junction?
Uh-huh. Did I miss it?
What you... Okay, so that's a piece of it. Well, that's not it. That's an ovary. So when you feel the ovary, you got the hip, the curvature of the hip, and the belly button. But midway through, you will find a little round ball that feels like an almond. So palpate right here. This is her ovary. That's where you were at. Feel the little, just the top flat surface of an almond.
Yep.
That's the ovary.
Okay.
Okay. So the valve is actually lower than that. You can feel the hip bone kind of come straight out and feel the pooch, the nice little, it should be soft. The more, so if it's hard, we have some serious problems. So here's her, and it should be soft. That's the next problem. So you feel the water balloon, the little soft balloon, and you can hold it. This is when you can push that balloon back and forth on. Does that hurt?
Mm-mm.
Feel right here underneath my finger. And really, that's just where the soft tissue is, where that, you know, the small intestine connects into the large intestine. And it's softer than an ovary. Ovaries tend to lay flat in the belly. Now, one thing that I would like to tell you is when you go to do a pelvic exam, most of the time doctors do not know where your ovaries are. You didn't hear that. Okay? They go, they do the medical mash, they squish the uterus and the belly towards their hand. If they don't feel anything, you should be fine. A lot of docs can't actually feel it. If you can actually get in here and palpate the borders of it, you'll know where you're looking ahead of time. And sometimes you can find a tumor or cyst on that ovary already. You can feel those on palpation through the belly. And the uterus is, you know, they always show you the picture of it standing up. It actually doesn't stand up. A uterus is truly kind of like a bat. It folds over the bladder. The bladder will be here, and the ovaries stretch out behind it, deeper in the belly. So the head of the uterus is up here. The back of it curves down, and then the ovaries are out here underneath. It's not interesting. So it's not that beautiful diagram. That's a lie. But, I mean, the parts are there, but it truly is in a different shape. Okay, so now that you felt the ovary on this side, can you find it on that side?
So, pelvis to belly button.
Yep.
Right? And so it should be right there.
Yep, about midway. Sometimes, like I said, they reach back, and so they are not always in the same position. And the broad ligament was always like a question to me. You know, they're like, oh, my broad ligament. Let's see. Yeah, right here. So that almond shape is it. The broad ligament is like a sheet. It overlays all the pelvic organs. So when women are like, my broad ligament hurts here or here, yeah, she's got a good ovary right there. That broad ligament covers from the front of the abdomen all the way to the back spine. It just overlays the uterus, the ovaries, that whole area as a flat sheet. So there's that one.
Okay, so now we have found the liver,
yep,
the gallbladder, the pyloric sphincter, and we've actually palpated the stomach, and the ileocecal valve, right?
Right. Okay, so kidneys are another thing you're going to be asked to palpate, right? Kidneys are a little bit harder. Remember that the right kidney is lower than the left kidney is because the liver pushes everything down. The liver's huge, okay? So it pushes everything down. So the right kidney is easier to palpate. The left kidney, you should only feel the bottom half of the kidney. The right kidney, you can hold in your hand. So when you go to find a kidney, you'll feel the hips and you feel these muscles, right? The little six-pack muscles that come in here. There's actually a trough in between there, right about here. And if you feel inside that trough, you can't push it in, or you should be able to push a kidney away, which is what we want. A solid kidney means we have problems. We have tumors, we have something else going. A free-floating kidney is what, you know, is a healthy kidney. So if you come in and you just sink in, you should be able to feel a more solid organ right here. Once you find it, you can actually take your hand and sink in the palm of your hand. You can actually hold it. It's like an egg in your hand. And you can appreciate both sides of that kidney. Back in the back, you have a triangle, and I'll hand out you at handouts. You can actually come into the back into, it's called Greenfeld's triangle. You find that spot and you can actually push this kidney and have it tap up on your hand on the other side. Sometimes it helps too. Do you want to bend your knees? If they bend their knees, it opens up that triangle in the back more and allows you more flexibility to get inside that belly. Feel that? And the patient, you can ask the patient because they can actually feel that kidney move around inside there. And they're like, what is that? That's a kidney, right? Here's a kidney. This whole section, there's this egg right here. The kidney is actually surrounded by fat, so you don't have to worry about damaging that kidney, but you can actually come down and hold it in your hand. So I'm gonna trade you places and let you come hold that. Come right in.
There. Do you feel it?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
You're good. Okay. So doesn't it feel weird?
Yeah.
So you can hold that little egg. Good time for Easter, right? That little egg, that kidney egg right there. This one is higher, so you'll find that same canal, right? That little cheater spot. This is where the body is going to let me in, right? And I'm going to come in. You can use your fingers. Just make sure you use the flat part. Don't jab them. The body guards itself, so it'll lock those muscles tight, and you won't be able to get in if you use a sharper touch. So you just want to use the flat part of your fingers and actually just palpate, surf your way in, and appreciate that. Feel that?
Mm-hmm.
Right there, you can feel the tip of the edge is just right here. They always tell you to find the spleen, check and see if there's a large spleen. Spleens are up higher, and if you were truly to palpate a spleen, it is actually like a soft custard inside a sac. And so when you feel it, you have to realize that it's a very light touch. It looks like I'm going deep. And I am, but I'm not going deep forcefully. I'm going in more flat and surfing down to actually start to palpate where that's at.
Right there, huh?
Mm-hmm. You feel it? Mm-hmm. It feels like a sack right up underneath there. Just like, to me, it feels like custard wrapped in saran wrap. So when you feel it, you can feel that there's something there, but you can sink into it pretty readily. Now, if it was enlarged with blood, it would be tight and hard and pushed down. That's when you can say, I palpated the spleen and it's enlarged, because it's easy to palpate and it's down farther. But they're hard to find.
Right there?
Mm-hmm. Okay. Kind of different, huh?
Uh-huh.
So that, I think one of the last things you're really going to use as a provider is finding the aorta. With your hands, you can see the midline. The aorta comes down through the abdomen. You can actually just let your hand kind of sink in and start to appreciate where you feel a heartbeat. Usually you won't feel a very strong heartbeat with the aorta until you're dead on it. Right here. So even no matter the size of your patient, size does not really matter. It's the skill of your hands. And people will tell you, oh, that patient was too obese, you can't palpate anything. That's not true. Unless they have a serious problem, you can use the skill of your hand to actually touch the patient, go down and palpate what you're finding. And you can track the aorta all the way down. It comes down and then it splits off into two, and you can track it as it tracks all the way down. You feel it?
I felt it and then I lost it.
Another trick of the trade is when you're palpating, palpate to feel difference, right? So you relax your total muscles, because if your muscles are tense, you're going to feel your own. If you relax everything out and just feel the difference in the tissue, you'll actually start to feel where it starts to jump out at you. The body will kind of take that piece and you can hold that in. Now if you listen, stick your stethoscope there, you can hear the pulsing. If you hear brewy, you have a problem. A lot of times, you know, they'll tell you, listen for a brewy, and they just tell you to stick it on the abdomen. What if you're not on it? Like, it really helps to kind of come in and actually palpate where that aorta is.
And then were you gonna show us the sigmoid colon?
So the sigmoid colon, the colon comes up and it wraps around here. This loop actually either can come straight over, which is rare. It actually kind of hangs, comes back up, and then it takes a dive to the back of your body and then comes in from there down in. Sorry, that's tickly, huh?
Oh, yes.
All the way down. Okay. So if you want to find the sigmoid colon, find their hip bone, and then you've got to sink in. And it actually, remember, this takes a dive to the back by your spine, coils around to an S-curve and comes down into the rectum, because you've got the colon, you've got a uterus that sits up on top of here in the vaginal canal, and you've got a bladder. On men, you've got the colon, you've got a larger bladder, and you've got a prostate sitting up underneath that. So you've got to go weave through around all of those places. So find the hip bone, find your landmarks that you know. Right, take a belly and just kind of start to sink in. A colon, you can actually follow from the back side, right here, okay? Follow that colon in. Can you feel that? Mm-hmm. It's sharp. Colons are sharp. And you can feel it right here as it starts to take a dive into the back, right? And then it'll S-curve. If you keep going, you can feel the edge. If you come over here, that edge is gone, that soft tissue, that small intestine. If you come over here, you can lip that colon, actually, and hold it in your two hands. If they're constipated a lot, you can feel it right there. Mm-hmm. That's one thing when you do the massages, if you come down, up, and then back down around, you can actually help push it out back. But that sigmoid colon is right here. So think of diseases that hit the sigmoid colon. That's what you're feeling for. If I have pain in the abdomen and some rectal bleeding, or you know what I mean, what are the diseases that hit this part of the colon? If I come in on their belly, I can wrap my fingers around there and push on that area, and they are having problems, they're going to let you know. You want to feel it?
Yeah.
So it's just right.
Can I switch places with you?
Yeah. I feel like while I'm doing this talking, I'm sorry. When you find it, it should provide a wall. So you'll be at the top of it. If you come below that, you can actually feel both sides.
There.
You feel it?
Uh-huh.
She's like, yeah, and it's sharp. The sigmoid colon can be sharp. Remember, the stool is soft and runny when it hits here. By the time it makes it all the way around here, it's getting pretty firm.
Oh, and I actually so you can felt feel the stool it. Move through there.
Yeah.
That was interesting.
You can feel things move through.
So if you were looking at diverticulitis, let's say, mm-hmm. for chance, you would have definite pain right here.
You would, healthy. Because most of the time, this is where the diverticula are, and it's inflamed. So it wouldn't just be like a sharp, ow, you're poking me from uh-huh. the inside. It would be a burning sharp.
Right.
And people would be like, that's my pain, I can feel it right there. And they're like, okay, this is not a colon pain, this is diverticulitis. So let's do the workup for diverticulitis. The whole point of the physical exam is to combine it with their history and then be very specific on what you're ordering so that you can make your differential diagnosis the most accurate it can possibly be.
Gotcha.
Anything else?
No, I think that's it. That was wonderful. Thank you so much.
You're welcome.